Good afternoon. Thank you very much for the invitation. I am so sorry for my English because it's not my language and I can't speak it very well. But I try to do it as good as I can. So I want to say something. First, I arrived in the afternoon due to a very tight flight schedule, but in time to listen the emotional and very important intervention of Zeynep Barol, for whose right we stand up in the European Parliament, and we have collected signatures to support her and her fight as woman, as doctor, and also as holder of human rights. I would like to begin my speech by thanking the host of this event. I am proud to be able to participate in this UE initiative that tries to make it visible how climate change affects different areas related to health. I would like to appeal to the European Union to change. Okay.
Dicono che la traduzione è a 6, la traduzione è al canale 6.
Guardate che innesca il microfono in modo premente.
I was saying that I would like to appeal to the European Union to change urgently the policy, mainly those that may have a harmful impact at health conditions of population. In a few days, I will participate as representative of the official delegation of the UE in the Conference of the Parties of the United Nations. In the battle against climate change, we should be accomplished the commitment in the laws and image fund to be able to split the countries most affected by natural disasters, the certification, gradual increase in temperature and other adverse situations, and try to adapt them to the new scenario created by climate change. We must achieve financial commitments from the most developed countries that are the ones that have contaminated the most to date. It's a question of historical responsibility. It is necessary to defend the right to food that goes beyond the food sovereignty that we defend so much, since it's a global concept that involves a way of life and also our relation with the food. We are what we eat. We are into a spiral of industrial consumerism where multinationals press to implement their parasite production and distribution model that devastates everything in its path. I have seen firsthand the expropriation and land grabbing in Brazil to the Guarani trees by macro companies and corporations. We have fought in Parliament with my partner Katarina Konecka a battle against the exploitation of palm oil, whose consumption affects public health while destroying the environment. Also, my colleague in Boylan from Sinn Féin, in her defense of the European Citizen Initiative Right to Water, call out for free access to water for all. According to the focus of the G7 summit, the dangerous decisions made by the most powerful states and private multinational companies. There are no goals of how to improve sustainability, welfare, disease reduction, or universal access to common goods, such as water and land exploitation. However, they propose to reduce the right to health and dignity for a commercial exchange and that supports the costs that have to be assumed by citizens. It's the next steps toward the privatization of the healthcare and the public structures. The austerity policies promulgated by the European Union has the approval of multinationals, pharmaceutical lobbies, and other private entities that benefit from the most basic need, that is the healthcare. From Podemos, we have denounced this on different occasions. During economic crisis, the conservative government shouts in basic service to the population. These governments are answering a liberal way of thinking that leaves the citizen lack in fundamental rights. This international forum should be a voice in defense of the basic universal rights for each citizen of the world. Also for the free access to medicines without being prisoner of the high prices of private patents and their pharmaceutical lobbies. We have the obligation to guarantee access to basic therapies and to be audacious legalizing medical treatments such as cannabis that have given the solution to an inimaginable chronic pain. Such access and the dignity of vulnerable people is one of the central goals of the UNEL and MIPS engaged in the environment and public health commitment. We are ready to continue cooperation based on your suggestions and the riches of this debate. I apologize because my English and because I couldn't follow the whole debate because my flight program from abroad. Thank you for your attention.